here.
That step down? I got it.
Viewers.
I don't remember bumping that.
I'll look up.
Do you want to go here? Do you want to go? Yeah, please. Maybe.
Side. This one's eroded away at the top there. The middle one is okay. This back one, it looks like it might be eroded as well. This was a good running tractor. Before it started getting water in the cylinders, so it, I'm not expecting any mechanical problems. Yeah, look at that though. Maybe that's okay, but this is a lot of metal eroded away right there. Kind of weird. Not super excited about that. I have to turn it over and bring it up to the top, I guess, and see what they look like more closely, but just look at the head. Tip of the injector. Nice and rusty as it should be. So if you're looking for if water get in, it'd be like a straight line from one of these guys. In the middle here or something. I don't know if that tractor has wet sleeves though. If it does, that could complicate things a little bit. But you grab that screwdriver or a flat scraper. Right here. That looks like a blowout to me. This carbon right there. Let's see. What's this? Yeah, right there. That's definitely a head gasket blow.
Move your light. Yeah.
Right here. Definitely. Anytime now. Fluid. Thank you. Happy day. Torque is safe for 5/16 grade 5. The half inch ones don't go that low. I can eyeball. I know what how much that is. Okay. Click, 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 click. Head hard to move around, but I think definitely easier to put that on now than it would be to get it on there because you're fighting with the whatever crap.
Where are my bolts? Out of King Cock.
Yeah, something like that.
This is King. The albino. We must kill the albino.
I can charge from that right.
Good.
Okay.
That idiot was me. It was me. I left them out in the way. I forgot to put them away.
Right there.
Okay. I don't like poor gaskets because they squeeze out the sides. All screwed up. So we had a bad hydraulic leak in the front of the tractor. Thought it was a hose at first, but I got the cylinder off here, and it's kind of a non-standard deal where they're running hydraulic pressure through the ends of the rod. Where the leak seems to be coming from is this bad O-ring here, which goes on this end of the rod and seals it. Camera will focus. Seals it into this junction block. So that should be an easy fix. I mean, the whole thing probably benefit from being rebuilt, but that's where our big leaker is coming from, so. See if it works.
Well, it did just pull out when I put it in there.
Thank you.
No, that doesn't sound right.
No,
really,
I think those injectors might be sticking open.
I think they are. It's flooding. It should not be spewing
yeah,
that white smoke.
I think those injectors are sticking.
Yeah.
They shouldn't be blowing that much white smoke.
No, and you can hear. You could hear the knot getting worse and worse and
yeah.
worse.
So it's flooding with fuel.
Yeah.
There was water in the cylinders. The injectors, they got wet.
And rusty.
And a little bit of rust on them. I cleaned them up, but...
Did you... Are those ones you can split apart or no?
Yeah, they're rebuildable,
yeah.
Okay. We're going to have to do with fuel injectors, I think.
Yep. Bad thing.
That's probably not going to self-correct. Okay, we've got to rebuild injectors here, like we thought. One was dumping fuel into the cylinder, and another had a poor spray pattern, so hopefully this will solve that issue. I can just remember how they go back together. Where are my hold downs? Once again, those O-rings are not going to allow the injector to go down in, so I'm just going to leave them up on top like they were before. Might not be correct, but I don't know what else to do about it. Can't really run it without them. Turn lines,
right,
just dump
right.
fuel everywhere. Yeah.
You don't run without them, but.
Well, yeah, probably. Try this stuff first. I don't think it's fuel rated, but it feels like it's gonna go on there.
At the very least, we can run it.
Yeah, we can get some proper line. Will you give me some cutters, please? It's not the way to do it. These injectors here a little bit, but they probably re-bleed the system, so I don't know why I tightened them up in the first place, but
Yeah, we'll get a little.
Well, we didn't flush blow the cylinders out before we started it, so. Yeah, start it. Injector isn't sealing properly in the bore, but it's no, it's not so bad it doesn't run, but we're getting little puffs of air, a little bit of vapor past.
Yeah, I've heard you can get away with just running it hot for a while and blowing it out, but
we did not arc the terminals, first of all.
Oh, it just goes right there?
Yeah, the guy at H&H Diesel wanted to know if I had a 22 RE engine for sale. It's on my truck. He's like, cool truck, yeah. I'm looking for a 22 RE. I'm like, me too.
You know, I got some wiring problems to figure out here before we can really use this thing. None of the gauges are working, only some of the dummy lights seem to be functioning. And seeing as how it was probably overheated in the first place above the head gasket, I think we want that gauge working in case we have some other problem that we're not aware of yet. So let's see if we can do some diagnosis here. Sure, this guy is high low. The headlights, I guess. And pull the other side off, and we'll get some light in there. Would have been easier with the hood off, but I'm glad to have that picked up off the floor. It's taking up a lot of space. So. There we go. Well. Let's not trust a visual test, let's do it. Let's hold them out and see if they're okay. I think I checked that one already, didn't I? No, maybe not. That's a 30 amp. I'm gonna call that blown, we'll check it here. But looks thoroughly melted. Now these are just labeled. I knew what they were, but yeah, I'm not seeing any low readings, but yeah, you can kind of see it, but that's pretty well melted, I think. It's still making contact, but only barely. That's supposed to be a 30 amper, so.
That one is no good.
Bad fuse?
Yeah, I don't think it's the right one, though, for our dash lights.
I got a new gauge to put in here. It's very frigid outside today. It's kind of unpleasant, but just chomp at the bit to get this thing replaced, so. To the top of that.
More?
Yep. One more. Yeah, it's pretty good. They rounded or something there. Thank you.
it should be anyway.